Good afternoon, and ang aktuang testing karon is ngano nga gikinahanglan ta nga kinahanglan nga mag-function good ang faithful ministry sa church o sa body of Christ, even within the local church, the faithful ministry must function. This is as far as the report conducted by, and that is the, in America, is submitting a statistics to this says, 1,800 pastors leave the ministry every month. Okay? It says here, nabasa niyo niya, 40% of pastors will not be in ministry in 10 years. 50% of pastors feel unable to meet the needs of the job. Then 80% believe that pastoral ministry negatively affects their families. 45% of pastors say they've experienced depression or burnout to the extent they needed a leave of absence from ministry. 33% felt burned out within their first 5 years of ministry. So there is no way to entirely alleviate the pressure that pastors face on a daily basis. However, the strain is greatly compounded when the fivefold ministry gaps are not fully operating in churches today. That's why it is not God's intention for pastors to attempt to equip, okay, and by himself, of the body alone by themselves. There are no scriptures that suggest that one senior shepherd can do all the job. Fivefold ministers are meant to cooperate in their special giftings and abilities and together govern, guide, gather, ground, and guard. Hallelujah. Okay, brethren, there is a need in the restoration of these ministries today, for it is a catalyst for Christian unity and spiritual maturity, without which the church will remain divided, immature, and ill-equipped. So there is a very, very kining pagkinahanglan sa fivefold ministry nga ma is reestablished, reactivate, or restored in the body of Christ. And it is sad to say that right now, as the whole, the body of Christ is concerned, not, I think, 30% or 20%, only 20% or 30% only, I think, is exercising or practicing the fivefold ministry. The remaining, I think, 80, I do not know, but here in the Philippines, I think it is only here in the Pulug City that the fivefold ministry is functioning. Amen?
Amen.
Even in Cebu, I have learned pastors or local churches who are trying to implement the fivefold ministry, but actually they are still far from the truth when it comes to biblical implementation of the fivefold ministry. So, because I just want you to encourage regarding the fivefold ministry, its importance, because I will be speaking on the ministry of the apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers. Maybe I will go back later on. So, ani ka mag-focus ni ini? The fivefold ministry defined and understanding the fivefold ministry from the Greek perspective. But before that, kining, let me just give a bird's eye view or just a summary how the fivefold ministry developed, or it there is an evolution of the fivefold ministry, how the fivefold ministry in Ephesians chapter 4:11 was established. Paul, by the Spirit of God, of course, gisulti din niya regarding the fivefold ministry nga diha ra sa Epeso, sa kuan dito sa, of course, during this, his time, wala niya isulti sa Corinth, wala niya isulti sa ubad ng mga iyang gisulatan dito lang niya sa Epeso, because at this moment, at this time, the church is now established during their time. Kamo na nga nakumpleto na, na-establish na ang church as a body during these times, unya mo na nga kung imong tanawon niya ang diha sa current regarding the threefold ministry nga gingod sa 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and he sits some in the church to be firstly apostles, secondly prophets, thirdly teachers. Okay, nauna na siya. Then before before he wrote Ephesians, he wrote 1 Corinth. So doon na evolution. Okay, so naibulota nga sa this Matthew chapter 10, of course not before Matthew chapter 10, wala usa ang Ginoo magtawag sa iyahang mga sakop, kanang iya mga as a group nga apostles, no? Iyang gitawag usa sila nga mga disciples. They are still learners. They are students. But later on, in Matthew chapter 10 verse 2, ikaw naman ay kining, yan naman ay girelate na lang. That is already narrated in Matthew chapter 10, kung sa pagi sa ministry ng Jesus. Primero, disciples, then when they now learn the trade of gospel ministry or preaching the gospel of the kingdom, Jesus now sent them. That's why they call it, they call him, these disciples now apostles. The first word here mentioned apostle in Matthew chapter 10 verse 2. So, kining mga dosen niya nga mga tinunan, mga disciples, now he calls them apostles, di ba? Na mo yung Biblia niya, ito, tanaw na to. Matthew chapter 10, verses 1, then 2. Okay?
Itigong ni Jesus ang iyang napulog duha ka tinun-an o ginatagan niya sila gahong sa pagtingilin sa mga dahutang espiritu o sa pag-ayo sa tanang sakit o balatian dos. Mao kini ang mga ngalan sa napulog duha ka apostol.
Okay. Diara. Sa primero, gitigom niya ang disipulos. Pero sa kalitra, sa diha ang ipadala na niya, ngayon na siya ni, now, maukin niya ang mga ngalan sa iyang dusi ka mga apostoles. Si Simon, kay Padayong Brad.
Ang una, si Simon, nagingan lag Pedro, ang iyang iksoon nga si Andres, si Santiago, o ang iyang iksoon nga si Juan, mga anak ni Sibilio, si Felipe, o si Bartolome, si Tomas, o si Mateo, ang kubrador sa buhis, si Santiago, ang anak ni Alfeo, o si Tadeo, si Simon nga Patriota, o si Judas Iscariote, ang nagbuthi kang Jesus.
Okay, so mauni ang inguna ko pagsugod sa iyang ministry ni Ginoong Jesus, nga apil na niya ang iyang mga tinunan. At first, si Ginoong Jesus sila ang nagwali, nagayo mga masakiton, di ba? O niya, ang iyang mga apostoles, mga evangelistra. Oh, kayo kuyogra, tanaw. That is how the Orientals teach. Okay, sa diha na magtudlo sila sa ilang mga disciples, the word matites or the disciple or learner in the Greek, and the word didaskalos in Greek teacher or teaching, is there is a relation between them nga ang ilahang pagkakuan isuod, relation good nila. The Lord built a relationship with His 12 disciples for 3 years, 3.5 years, di ba? Okay? So, sa primero nga ilahang ibong na to, first stage of their relationship was a teacher and a student. But when they now learn, si Ginoong Jesus, dili na sila gingan lang niya nga mga tinunan, pero mga apostoles. Okay? So, mauna siya ang mahimong mga kasi magbubuhat na ni Ginoong Jesus. Because what the Lord now is doing, these 12 are also doing what the Lord is doing. They have now learned. So, kining do si way bangko nila. Kasabot mo bangko ka ng mga basketball players bitaw, di ba? Kinsi sila, pero lima laong mo play. Sa, dire sa pagka mga tinawag sa mga apostoles, walay bangko nila. Tanan, gipadala. And that is the concept of the ministry. Walay usa sa inyo diri nga bangko. Amen?
Amen.
Salamat sa Ginoo nga kamo nagbuhat kay dili mahimo ang pagsangyaw during the time of Jesus. So the, of course, so the nation of Israel kung siya ra. So he trained 12. Diba? So this is the, diha nag-start ang concept sa dili ka ni fivefold ministry, but of course sa team ministry. Ngay gispadala nila, of course dili lang nagtawag siya og kining 12 nga gipadala niya, then iya po nagpadala siya 72, diba, sa I think Luke chapter 20 or Luke 15 or Luke chapter 10 or 20 nga gikuha po niya ang mga 72 nga mga tinun-an po niya disciples, pero wala yung ngalan dito tungod kay si Ginoong Jesus ang iyang gidevelop ang iyang inner core nga iyang kining mga disciples nga iyang gitrain nga mao kini ang mulangkob sa pagsugod sa as far as the apostles in Ephesians chapter 2 verse 20 that the apostles and the prophets are the foundation of the church. Mula sa foundation unya katong 72 nga mga tawag sa Ginoo o gipadala, let me just Luke chapter 10 verse 1. Okay, after these things the Lord appointed other 70 o dire nga 70 o 72 di ay also and sent them 2 by 2 before his face into every city and place with whither himself would come. Okay. Therefore see unto them, the harvest truly is great. So money ang concept sa kanang ministry. Teamwork. Okay, ayang pag send is 2 by 2, 2 and 2. So money ang primero nga kuan kining mga magbubuhat sa Ginoo, primero tinunan apostles, then pag-abot sa Acts chapter 6 verse 1, kinsay na ay kunha, Acts chapter 6 verse 1, diri na makita nato nga nadugangan. This is now after the ascension of Jesus Christ nga na nagsugo ang Ginoo sa Matthew chapter 28 verse 19 to 20 nga manglakaw kamo sa tibuok kalibutan, di ma magsangyo sa maayong balita. Then sa Acts chapter 1 verse 8 gihapon diha nag gipalig-on sa Ginoo ang iyang sugo may tungod sa gospel ministry nga nangyong siya, but he shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and he shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. But remember, kining mga apostles, wala sila usa kining ipadala hangtod nga they were filled with the Holy Spirit. Okay, money ato ni kuan. Then, of course, nipaluta during the day of the Pentecost, they were filled with the Holy Spirit. And chapter 3, of course, Acts chapter 2 or 3, Peter preached, pila yung nasululuwas, 3,000 were saved in one preaching. And there is a commentary that says, today, we have preached 3,000, only one saved. During the time of Peter, when they preached, one preaching ang naluwas, 3,000. Hallelujah. So, pagka Acts chapter 6 verse 1, diha nadugangan na pud og mga magbubuhat. Okay? So, deacons, di ba? Acts chapter 6 verse 1, nag-sikot diha og mga helpers sa church. Kaya dili na nila makaya. Okay? Kung imong tanaw ni Ginoong Jesus, wala siya ay deacons dito. Wala. Ang iya lang yung kanang mga kuara, mga apostles. Then, the reason is, and in those days, when the number of disciples was multiplied, there arose a murmuring of derision against the Hebrews because their widows were neglected in the daily ministration. Sibuhan mo din, may sibuhan mo din ko dire. Okay? Busa, mga igsuon, tungod ni ini, gipatigom sa napulo og duha ang panon sa mga tinunan og na nag-ingon, dili angay nga pagabiyaan namo ang pulong sa Dios og magsilbi kami sa mga lamisa. So mao na nga pagkabos sa verse 5 og kini nga kapayag hinguyunan sa tibuok nga panon og ilang gipili si Esteban, laki ka puno sa pagtuo sa Espiritu Santo og si Felipe mo na ang gingon mga deacons si sila tabang diha sa church. Dili sila nagwali, wala sila magwali, but they are also a part of the team. Okay? Appeal sila sa team nila sa mga apostles. Dili ngingon nga tungod kay di sila wala sila magwali nga dili sila appeal sa gospel ministry. No, they are included in the team ministry. Kay diha sa church kung way deacons, then ang pastor mahimo pa siya janitor. Wow, gamone kadaghanan ni tabo ako nakexperience ako na ako'y tour na ay pastor. Unya kining sa pa janitor niya kanang sa singing sa worship ministry ako ang magsista, ako musayo tanan-tanan kay bon mo na kanang labi ng pioneering church. Pero bisan pa gani kung mugro ang church kadaghanan ang pastor ang mulihok ni tan mo nga kapoy. Mo na gingo da nga ang mga pastor kadaghanan ma-burn out tungkol sa kakapoy sa ilang trabaho. Okay, so money ang nitabo deacons, then ang pagkumana na hitabo is sa Acts chapter 21 verse 8. Mao ni makita nato nga do nanay evangelist, di ba? Acts chapter 21 verse 8. And the next day, we that were of Paul's company departed and came into Caesarea. Pero di agyapon sa Acts chapter 6, si Stephen was a member of the deacons, diba? Si Stephen og si Philippe. Okay. Unya, kining si Stephen nagwali, asama commentator says that Stephen was really an evangelist while he was defending, of course, to the kadang-kadang nga misupak sa preaching. Unya nagwali siya, unya kining diha ma wala diha gihingon nga evangelist siya, pero others says that he was an evangelist. Pero sa Acts 21 verse 8 diri si Juan Paul si Philip. Okay, the next day that were a Paul's company party came unto Caesarea, and we entered unto the house of Philip the evangelist. So evangelist which was one of the seven and abode with them. Then Acts 21 verse 10, after we had been there a number of days, a prophet named Agabus came down from Judea. So di anay mga giftings nga gihatag sa Ginoo diha sa church. Doon anay apostle, doon anay deacon, doon anay evangelist, karon doon anay prophet. So wa pay pastor dire, wa pay teacher diha. Okay, so pag sa Acts chapter 13, now we see teachers and prophets also manina kon dire sa record. Acts 13 verse 1, in the church of at Antioch there were prophets and teachers. Okay, nanay prophets og teachers Barnabas, okay, Simeon called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, who had been brought up with Herod the Tetrarch, and Saul. So, wala pa diha ma-mention ang pastor. Okay? So, in the book of Acts, although wala ma-mention ang pastors, kandang giisgutan diha ng elders, they are reckoned as pastors at the time. Pero dili pa, wala pa kaya sila ma-establish. So, in Paul in writing to the Corinthian Christians says, 1 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 27, now ye are the body of Christ and members in particular. Okay, 28, and God that set some in the church, first apostles, secondarily prophets, thirdly teachers, after that miracles, then gifts of healings. So diri na po dali yung mga giftings, diri nga nadugang na po, okay? Okay, ang wala dito, of course, and apostles, prophets, and teachers, to miracles, okay? Workers of miracles, nana, then gifts of healings, helps, governments, diversities of tongues. So, mauna, nadunggang ng mga gifting sa church, but of course, ang ato karon pagbugata mo, good, ang the pillar of the church are the fivefold ministry, kanang apostle, prophets, evangelists. Okay, so pag-abot diri sa verse 29, naging are all apostles, are all prophets. This is of course referring to Paul's explanation nga dili pod tanan mga apostle. Even sa atong group karon diri sa ato ang ministry, dili tanan mo nga naa sa fivefold ministry. Do you believe that?
Amen.
So dili ni kagool bang kaigsoonan ha. Kay ang Ginoo ang mopili ani dili si Brother Mark no. He has no hand as far as calling into the ministry is concerned. Ang buluhat ni is to guide, okay, to teach kung unsa inyong calling. Okay. Although sometimes of course the Lord will reveal to him kung unsa ang imong calling. Sa kuan kining the word said can be translated ordained. So is the Lord ordained apostles. Manaya number one is firstly. The word firstly is proton in the Greek, which means nga primarily. Manaya we will note later that the ministry of the apostles, they are the frontliners in the ministry. Sila gyud ang manguna. Okay. Manaya secondarily prophets, then thirdly teachers. Okay, so sugod na tadi. That is just an introduction, no? Introduction pa nang ito, ah. Regarding the fivefold ministry. So, atong may buntang sa una-una nga, ang fivefold ministry, wala madritso. Dito lang na isulat sa Ephesians chapter 4:11. Okay, nakamemorize na mo siguro, ana. Unya, diha sa atong sa King James Version, nakamemorize mo, ana, sa ubang mga translation. Pero, how it is understood or translated sa pangunahuna diya sa Greek language. This is the Greek language or this is the Greek understanding as far as the translation sa ato sa English, no? But na kayo pasabot nga diya sa Greek, maokini ang buti pasabot nga nga statement o nga words. So ang ato diya sa King James Version naging ulan diha nga and he gives some asa to be apostles, some to be prophets, some to be evangelists, and some to be pastors and teachers. But how the Greek is understood implementing or employing the Greek grammar, maonis ya. Okay? And he gives some indeed. Oh, duga pada is emphatically, categorically, or without a doubt. Some to be apostles. And he gives some indeed, emphatically, categorically, or without a doubt. Some to be prophets. Okay? And he gives some indeed, emphatically, categorically, or this is a permission to be evangelist. And he gives some indeed, emphatically, categorically, some to be pastors. Mone ang pagsabot niya. Which means nga, he really give daily, there is no doubt that the Lord give apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers. Mone. And he gives some emphatically, categorically, some to be pastors, and he gives some indeed, emphatically, categorically, some to be teachers. This is how we understand from the Greek construction grammar. Kimona nga, taas good kung mahurot niya na. Although sa ako, pwede nga ako madugang ni akong personal translation, kaya the word niya, and he gives some, I translate it, and the Lord continuously supply apostle, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers. There is no break in this in the giving of the apostles. Walay hunong mga kaigsuonan. Kaya ako, this is what I argue to those who do not believe in the continuation of the apostolic and the prophetic ministry. Ngayon ko, if there were no apostles, then the church will not go anywhere. Dito lang sa panahon nila Pablo unta. But we, ano, kining we reach, diri, abot din sa ato sa Pilipinas, di ba? Kaya ang mga apostles actually, they are the one responsible in what? Church planting. Wala lang sila kahibalo nga ang church planter kin mga missionaries are actually apostles. Kaya giwala na sa ilahang pagtulon na silang una-una, nga wala na kong apostol, kaya pagkamatay sa mga apostles, ng mga original apostles, the ministry of the apostles and the ministry of the prophets also died with them. Yeah. And who is responsible in teaching this? nga mawala na kuno ng apostolic ministry or the prophetic ministry is John Calvin. Mga reform na sila. I have my record that wala na ko kuan kan tuanas akong laing ako ang kanang powerpoints. He was responsible in teaching to the reformers, no? Mga reformers nila. Okay, ang the Roman Catholic Church at the time, giwala na po na nila, even before the Reformation, wala na po na sila. Kaya ang ilang gipataas, ang mga bishop. Okay, and let me just, may makita niyo akong record regarding this. Asan niya? Okay, nanay ko. Okay, let me read this. Ang gusto na ko nga kining magtulog ko na ako yung ani kay usay makalimot ko mas may ay suwat gyud diri. Asa ni? Okay, ana dia. Ako ni basahon na. Ako ni basahon diri kay para ba diri sunato. Church blueprint for ministry is inscribed in Ephesians 4:11. But in my study, why the ministry disappeared like bubbles in the seashore dates back to the time of the so-called church fathers. Okay, church fathers, that is, after the death of the 12 apostles, mauna siya ang mipulis sa church, sa pagdumala. Mga church fathers sila, Cyprian, I think it is Ignatius. Church fathers, particularly Ignatius, in his epistle to the Smyrnians, written around 112 or 112, begin to elevate the authority of the bishop above all others. Mone, elevate niya ng bishop. Mone, gingo na kisir na ko sa inyo, ha, nga ang bishop labaw sa apostle sa private of Juan. Pero actually, during this time, they are just appointed. Bishop is not a calling. Okay? It is desired, meaning diha, di ba? So, begin to elevate the authority of the bishop above all others. He states, quote, all of you follow the bishop as Jesus Christ followed the Father, and follow the presbytery as the apostles. So, gipulihan nila ang actually ang apostles ng bishop. Mo nila ba nila? Nawala ng apostles. So, dito pa, wala na yung apostles, bishop na mo nalabaw nila. Diha na nagsugod. Okay? And respect the deacons as the commandment of God, where the bishop appears, there let the people be, just as whosoever Christ Jesus is, there is the Catholic Church. It is in the writing of Ignatius where calls for the sole authority of the bishop are observed. Muna nga kung imong tanawon diya sa hierarchy sa Roman Catholicism, ang Pope actually is a bishop. Muna yung Archbishop din Pope na siya diya. Pero ang iyong kon is Bishop na siya. Okay? Heresies and persecution eventually forced the early church to link ecclesial authority to apostolic succession. Again in 248 AD, Cyprian, Bishop of Carthage, writing around the year 248, declared, our Lord, okay, ilang gamit nilang Ginoo, ordered the high office of bishop. Okay, nagipaligo niya. Okay, diha na nawala ni God. And the system of his church, when he speaks in the gospel and says to Peter, the word Peter, man ang ilang gigabit ng verse, etc. Then, Edge has followed Edge and Bishop has followed Bishop in succession. So that the church is founded on the bishops, not on the apostolic ministry. Nawala na diha. See, from then on, the bishop will become the sole and supreme authority over the church. Okay, diha na nawala na. So this is the story why the apostolic ministry or the papal ministry disappeared. The conversion of Emperor Constantine to Christianity in the first century only solidified this, as the Roman pontiff would later again be position of vicar of Christ. Mo na ang papa vicar of Christ, kapuli ni Kristo ba? Wala naman si Kristo nga magdumala sa simbahan, ang puli niya mao ang papa, which is not true. Because in the Bible, who is the vicar of Christ actually? Kinsa man? Kinsa kibalo? Kinsa may kapuli ni Kristo sa diyang ato sa langit unya giya sa church? Kinsa man? The Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen! It is the Holy Spirit, not a person nga sama sa ato, not mortal man. Kaya kung ang kita mga tao ang bilinan, dagang sayap. It is the Holy Spirit. So it is now the Holy Spirit that is actually the leader, the supreme leader of the church. Hallelujah. Today. Amen. Amen. So come on, Emo. Very good.